Humans on a mass scale have been fascinated with time travel since the Industrial Revolution. Something about them moving backwards and forwards through time has fascinated us. But so far as we know, time travel is the stuff of fiction, best experienced in movies like Back to the Future. Some think time travel will one day be possible, but if so, why haven't we come across any evidence of it? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that likes to answer a breadth of questions on topics like history, politics, science, and space and pop culture. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, why haven't we met time travelers yet? Before we fly through this video, I just want to ask you guys to hit that thumbs up button if you like our content. Also, let us know which era you want to travel to if you had the choice. I'm torn between going back to see the dinosaurs or experiencing the swinging 60s. Let me know where you would go in the comment section down below. Also, if you're a time traveler and you're watching this, make yourself known. Okay, time travelers. Where are they? Widespread human fascination with time travel came after the Industrial Revolution, when eras stopped spanning hundreds of years, but started spanning decades instead. Prior to the revolution, people could expect their lives to be reasonably similar to that of their parents and their grandparents. Change was slower, and if there was any fascination with history, it would be over lengthier periods of time. Now though, my mum's childhood in the 70s or my grandparents' lives during World War II, much more appealing and historically loaded and far removed from the life I'm living today. Since the space revolution, scientists have been theorizing and working towards ways in which we can travel through time. At the moment, traveling through time with ease doesn't work with our Earth laws of physics. However, it is speculated that once we master the ability to travel at the speed of light, we might have a fighting chance. Sadly, we're some way off that being a reality yet. Professor Stephen Hawking, amongst other big brains out there, theorized that we may be able to manipulate wormholes to travel through time too, but of course, we haven't come across any that we have the ability to travel through yet. All that being said, there was a time when humans hadn't yet invented the wheel or the internal combustion engine. In ancient civilizations, nobody would have conceived of the fast, effective plane travel that we have today, or the fact that one day the man might be able to walk on the moon. Just because we can't time travel today doesn't necessarily mean that we won't be able to. So that being said, if we assume that humans do get to that point where we can time travel, where on earth are all of the time travelers? Professor Stephen Hawking famously held a party for time travelers on June the 28th, 2009. He had canapes, cocktails, and flutes of champagne ready. He also had balloons and a big banner saying, "Welcome, time travelers." Of course, no time travel experiment would be complete without mailing the invites after the event in question, which is exactly what he did. You guessed it, nobody showed up, and all that beautiful Krug champagne went undrunk. Does this mean that time travelers do not exist, or are they avoiding us? There are three possibilities as to what might be going on here and why nobody attended Professor Hawking's party. The first one is pretty sad, and that is that time travelers do not exist because humans never managed to crack the space-time continuum. They never managed to invent time travel. Something on Earth or in space kills us off before we ever get there. What a buzzkill. The second is that perhaps we're living through the first ever time. To believe in time travel is to either wildly suspend disbelief, disregard paradoxes, or to believe that there may be parallel universes existing side by side that could allow for a future, a past, and a present to somehow exist together that can be traveled between. Although this would open a wider can of worms about cause and effect, and whether changing something would eradicate the outcome that led you to going back in time in the first place. Mind-boggling, I agree. So let's just stick a pin in that for a second. If parallel universes do exist, and this is the first time that we're living through history and we've not yet built a time machine, then how can we expect to see any time travelers? Offering a similar angle, Hawking's mate Kip Thorne wrote a great book called Black Holes and Time Warps. In this, he said the most feasible way of time traveling would be manipulating wormholes. However, he adds this would only allow people in the future to travel back as far as the invention of the time machine itself, and as that isn't yet, we wouldn't see any time travelers today. The third possibility? We have encountered time travelers, we just don't know it. Perhaps time travelers are being careful to leave no traces for fear of creating irreparable paradoxes. Some even argue that we have met them, we just aren't publicly accepting it. Recently, a man called Noah made worldwide headlines when he claimed to be a professional time traveler from the year 2030. Amongst other things, he says he's had a device in his hands that helps him time travel, which an X-ray does seem to back up. Similarly, a Greek man claims that he was shot through time to the year 3207 as part of a secret military experiment. He said that buildings were huge, the grass was a weird new colour, and that people flew in cars and lived among big animals and robots. Cool. Head on over to YouTube, you'll find dozens of semi-convincing videos of conversations with alleged time travellers. In 2016, archaeologists dug up an object that looked like a 2000s-era mobile phone, like spookily like one. Again, there is allegedly a time traveller talking on a phone to someone in Charlie Chaplin's 1928 movie The Circus. The hipster on the bridge in 1948. What's he up to? Some people even claim that Vladimir Putin is a time traveller. Are these hoaxes, or are there really time travellers out there already? Or do you think that the lack of steadfast proof means that there are no time travellers yet? Do you think there ever will be? Do you believe in parallel universes? I have so many questions, which means it's probably time to end this one. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below, and honestly, I can't wait to read them. I'm totally fascinated by this question, and I'd love to invite future me, if you're watching, to send me a message or a sign. Here's hoping that time travel will be invented in my lifetime anyway. Thank you guys for watching this video. Do make sure you leave a thumbs up and hit that notification bell. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video, but until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.